Just about a month ago, in fact, NSIC launched a B2B portal called nsicindia.com. Startups can actually go to the site and use it to buy and sell products and machinery, such as office supplies and electronics. But if you're looking for a cheaper option and bootstrap, Radhika Sadarangani tells you how.
When I say bootstrapping, it's about, it's like putting the pieces of the puzzle together.
Yes, as an entrepreneur who's just starting up, your business may well seem like a jigsaw puzzle. And putting the pieces together with little or no external funding is what is known as bootstrapping. It really means starting and running your business as a lean, mean, cost-saving machine. Sandeep Murthy, founder of ClearTrip.com and now an investor, stresses that having the mindset of bootstrapping is at the core of it all. Because every penny you save is a penny you don't have to raise later, and therefore you don't have to dilute.
Bootstrapping, being cost conscious, looking at how you can deliver your product and solution more efficiently is at the core of what every startup should be thinking about. I think you're trying to facilitate growth, you're trying to meet top line targets, but the reality is, if you can focus on ensuring that you're able to save money rather than necessarily spend to grow the top line, you'll be a more efficient company.
Some of the common ways you can bootstrap your startup are by saving on technology, saving on operations, saving on HR and recruitments, and of course, on office premises.
A few people and even fewer computers. This is what most startup office spaces look like. And that's fair, you have other things to worry about than having a snazzy office. But what if you have a client coming over to meet you, or you have to conduct a meeting via video conferencing? Well, we'll take you to a place where you can do just that.
Having a decent looking office can cost you a great deal. Save that money and instead go check out places like this one at Regis Business Center, which offer you a cool, sophisticated and prime office address to work out of. With over half of Regis's clients being startups, a shared office space is a common form of bootstrapping.
For startups, nothing is at stake because they are getting everything ready-made, the entire infrastructure is in place. We have got the most premium locations, we have got the best of facilities, we have got the most professional staff around, and moreover, the best thing is they need not to worry about their problems which are not related to their business objective. They just have to focus on their business, and rest of the problems, we are there to help them out.
So are you thinking, can I afford it? Well, at about 5,000 rupees an hour for a high-end meeting room that offers a video conferencing facility, or a physical office space at 20,000 per month, with no other overheads to worry about, these alternate office locations can cut your conventional office costs by nearly half. Office space is just the first hurdle in the race. Once that puzzle piece falls into place, you still have to worry about the next big one. Recruitment.
Your first three people are the most important in your company. Hire the best three people ever, invest 80% of your cash flows in that. Because those three people will bring you the rest 30 people. And trust me, good people attract good people.
As a bootstrapping startup, you can't afford a fancy recruitment agency or an HR team. Enter Sutra HR and Sutra Jobs. While Sutra HR is a paid consulting model, Sutra Jobs, a free job portal, is the perfect platform for startups, especially with its social media integration.
We are coming up with this interesting social media recruiting feature in Sutra Jobs, wherein you post a job on Sutra and it gets broadcasted on all these social media properties like LinkedIn, Facebook, Twitter automatically.
This brings us to technology, where you can save by using open source platforms. So, for instance, you can build your website using WordPress. For programming, you can also use open source programming languages like PHP instead of ASP. And maybe you can ramp up data using public mail domains and save server space.
We routed all the mails to Gmail, right? What that did was it saved us a lot of server space for emails. You know, we had heavy attachments we were sending to clients. So we integrated Gmail with it, and we were using 7 GB free space, right? Without even using our hard disks for that matter.
Also, you'd rather rent than buy. So in the first 3 or 4 months of your startup, rent out computers, ACs, even furniture. save on all overheads and bring down your capital expenditure. You can invest in these once you have a steady channel of cash flow.
If I were to just make a calculation of how much I saved via bootstrapping, I would have easily saved in the last 2 years at least 50 lakh rupees.
So even if you have capital available through family and your own savings, put that money aside instead of wasting it on stuff that you can bootstrap on. Inculcate the culture of saving every penny, make your business more cost efficient, and you will be a more competitive company.
And if you're looking for more strategies, simply read Chapter 5 called The Art of Bootstrapping from Guy Kawasaki's now legendary manual, The Art of the Start.